got in there. You don't want me to
okay,
you
want here.
Go ahead. Don't hesitate.
Now you hold this. Get that.
I wouldn't bring that. I think that.
One more thing we need to put out of here.
Back here is Ashley. And where you at, guys? That's the flower. We're talking about the flower here, huh? There's a flower that only grows here in Zion. And this flower is used as a royal flower to represent what is called Jerusalem. And it don't seem like I have it in here now, so let me see if I have this pamphlet. I put it in here.
I have so much stuff here.
I was trying to actually show your father, but yeah, before Zion, the ancient map that they had when our people took over the land again, you have these maps that pinpoint Jerusalem and the flower that grows right here.
And it's right before the house, and you only see that flower in springtime, right before Passover. And that flower identifies and allows you to identify the season of Passover. But that flower is well known to be the flower that grows only in Zion. But let me make a point here. It says in Solomon, it's called a lily. And Yeshua, what did he say? He says in Solomon, all of his power wasn't as beautiful as the what?
That lily.
And that lily grows right here. It's the only place in all Israel where it grows.
Is that the lily that they use to make the dye?
The same dye. You see that purple that was used for the temple. You see, and that was significant. And it's also,
see that was the difference between the fringes here, because you know the fringes here, you have the
purple, the blue, but it's actually purple. You see, so these are the little things that allow you to understand when you're actually walking here. You can actually see what's the difference. So what I did when I first came here, I drove up here. So we just happened to be walking. And Ola can tell you when we first came here, none of this was here. Huh?
Yeah.
All this is all new. But the point is that, and my family planted these first flowers here. But now you're getting the feeling of actually walking up to Zion. And as you walk up, you're gonna see some very interesting things, because you see Mount Olive in the distance? Mount Olive in the distance.
Yes.
Now, according to the scripture, the distance between Mount Olive is supposed to be Shabbat day's journey, which is the 2-mile journey. Mm-hmm. Now, as you're walking down here, you're going to walk down, you're going to continue to go down. And the distance between this mount, the bottom of this mount, and the beginning of Mount Olive is exactly 2 miles. Even as you say, I did that with the earth. Get to the bottom of this mount. You see that tree? You see those trees?
Yeah.
In fact, what I'm saying to you, the geography here fits the actual scripture of what's happening. It fits it. Two, three, four.